In this section, we'll introduce the major categories of manner of articulation. While place of articulation refers to where in the mouth the main obstruction is made, manner of articulation refers to how that obstruction is made. In other words, do the articulators come together so strongly that they completely stop all airflow temporarily? Or do the articulators make a very narrow space such that as air flows through that narrow space, it speeds up and creates a turbulent noise as it rushes out of the mouth? There are also other mechanics involving different articulators that we'll examine. Among the easiest of the manner categories to hear and feel are the stops. These sounds are also often referred to as plosives for reasons that we'll talk about in a moment. What defines a stop is that the articulators come together and create a complete closure that stops airflow entirely. This is why they're called stops, because you stop the airflow to produce them. While your articulators are closed, however, air is still trying to get from your lungs to the outside. So, as the air encounters a complete blockage created by the articulators, air pressure begins to build up behind that obstruction. When the articulators finally let go of the obstruction, that built-up air pressure is released, and the air sort of explodes out of the mouth. It's this small explosion of air that gives rise to the word plosive. The terms plosive and stop are interchangeable. They refer to the same sounds. Speaking broadly, linguists tend to prefer the word stop, and speech-language pathologists tend to use the word plosive. But they mean the same thing. Some examples of stop sounds are listed here, and if you compare these symbols to those in the place section, you'll see that the first two are bilabial sounds, the next two are alveolar sounds, and the last two are velar sounds. The next main manner category is called nasal. In many textbooks, you'll see these sounds referred to as nasal stops. Again, these two terms mean the same thing. Nasals are technically stops because there's a complete closure created by the articulators in the oral cavity. This is just like the stops that we just described earlier. What makes nasals different is that the velum, which controls airflow through the nose, is open for nasal sounds. Because the velum is open, air can flow freely through the nose. That's what makes these sounds nasal. Air is flowing through the nose, but it's stopped from flowing through the mouth. So nasal sounds have something in common with stop sounds, but they also have something that makes them quite different. Although technically it's accurate to call them nasal stops, in practice very few people do. It's far more common for people to use the shorthand word nasal to describe them. The nasals we have in English include m, n, and this odd-looking character that we saw in the last section, engma, which represents the velar nasal sound ng. The next manner category that we'll introduce is one that requires substantially less obstruction to produce. Instead of the articulators coming together completely, the articulators get pretty close to each other and then move away again. In essence, they glide from one position to another, and for this reason, they're called glides. There are two glides in English, w as in wet and y as in yes. Now, in the next movie, we'll cover the remaining types of manner of articulation.